Coming up next on Expedition Central Florida, we're going to Tavares to see the antique and classic boat show. Stay tuned. Welcome to Expedition Central Florida. I'm your host, Steve Hansen. This week, we are traveling to Wooten Park in Tavares for the Antique and Classic Boat Show. Please welcome my guests tonight. We have two of them, Terry Fiest and Dennis Ryan. It's a pleasure having you both with us tonight, gentlemen. I know the boat show takes a lot of preparation, and you two are important to the event. So why don't you tell us a little bit first, Terry, about this event. What do we have going on here?
Well, this is a very big event. We're part of the Antique and Classic Boat Society, which is a worldwide organization. They have 57 chapters located mostly throughout the U.S. and a few in Europe. And each one of these chapters has a boat show. And this is our annual show, and we start in March because of the weather here in Florida. So this is the opening of the boat show season. We're the kickoff show, and we literally set the pace for the rest of the chapters. And this event is so huge that we have people who actually save their spring vacation and bring the whole family down here, the boats, the kids, and everybody can come down and spend a few days at the boat show and then go to all the attractions here in Florida. So we usually draw from like 26 different states, mostly on the East Coast. Got visitors here this year from Canada and California and places like that. So it really is starting off great.
So it's a great way to start off the spring break for all the families and kids, and everyone a little bit different for the adults. They get to go to the boat show, and the kids get to go to the parks and all kinds of fun adventures, right?
Well, we just literally have something for everybody. It's a very entertaining 3 days. So,
excellent. I'm going to defer to our second guest over here so we can say hello, Dennis.
Yes.
Tell everyone where you're from and who you represent.
I'm from Cincinnati, and I'm president of the Antique Boat Center in Cincinnati. We're the largest dealer for sales and service for vintage, antique, and classic wood boats, and we've just become a modern Chris Craft dealer in Ohio.
Actually, while we're on that, we could probably segue right into these wonderfully lovely models we have right here. These are both Chris Craft?
Chris Craft,
yes. They're both Chris Craft.
And why don't, if we could get a close-up, I believe, on the fiberglass one on the table here. That's the newest model.
Yes, Chris Craft is still building fiberglass boats, and they've been building boats continuously for nearly 100 years. This is their Launch 25. It's a prototype model of what they're currently building, one of the models they build. And then, of course, the Racer sitting on the table is a sample of what they used to build with their solid mahogany runabouts.
So these are similar to some of the types of boats we would see at the show this week if we're heading over there.
That's correct. Uh-huh.
That's great. I would like to remind everyone watching at home, if you have a question that you'd like to ask Terry or Dennis, please call us at 1-800-901-9238. And that number should be at the bottom of your screen, so you can't forget it. Now, tell me a little bit about, Dennis, how you got started with boats, where your passion came from.
Well, my wife, she loved to boat. She wanted me to become a boater. I had a passion for the wood and the mahogany, and she actually purchased a little 16-footer as a birthday gift for me. And that was the beginning.
Gift.
And yeah, that was the beginning, and I've been hooked ever since.
And Terry, you must have been in it for quite a while now.
Well, I actually grew up, I was born and raised in Montana, and grew up in western Montana on a beautiful lake, and we had a lot of these vintage mahogany boats there, and that's where I actually started my relationship with the boats. My father had a boat when I was a kid, so I kind of grew up with them and just kind of stuck with it, and it's been a hobby that's turned out to be just an incredible avenue to meet people and travel, and it's been just a great hobby, so I've truly enjoyed it.
And how many years have you been the chairman of the boat show?
This is my 17th year as the show chairman. This is our 26th anniversary show, and I've been the chair for 17 years. So.
All right. How about a few of the events? What do you have for events at the show that you'd like to share with everyone watching so they know what they're going to expect when they come out to see all these boats?
Well, from the spectators' standpoint, the show actually starts on Friday morning. We go all day Friday, all day Saturday, half day on Sunday. And if you come to the show, you can expect to see about 115 of these beautiful boats like this in the water. We have a boat for sale corral we call the Field of Dreams. We have 50 boats in there for sale. So if you're in the market for a boat, you can certainly find a vintage boat similar to this. And then we have a huge land display of boats with a lot of decorative pieces and that sort of thing. And we have what we call the Antique Outboard Motor Club associated with it, vintage outboard motors, beautiful old outboard race boats. We've got 80 flea market vendors set up there where they sell nothing but nautical.
Some of the stuff that we're seeing right here on.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See, there's some of that. That was at the launch today when we were actually launching the boats there and everything. And this, like I say, this is our build-up day today. But this is just a sample of what you're going to see.
That's actually one of the resorters that was in our booth that was for sale.
So some of the boats there are just on display and others are for sale, basically.
Yes.
Okay. So you've got collectors and you've got buyers coming in from all over the place for this big, huge North American kickoff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we sure do, yeah.
And approximately how many boats do you have total?
Well, we probably will be real close to 300 boats. When I add them all up, you know, when I count all the smaller outboard boats and all the pieces there, it'll be pretty close to 300 boats.
What are some of the oldest boats that you have?
The oldest that I've seen today, and that varies because we actually have awards that we pass out at the show at on Sunday morning. And I actually set aside an award for a 100-year-old boat. So I actually look for a boat that's 100 years old.
Wow.
And in the past few years, we have had them. Some of the canoes are 100 years old, but it's hard to find, you know, something that's been around for 100 years. So that's one of our targets, to look for a 100-year-old boat. But most of them are built in the 20s. We got a lot of boats that are built in the 20s and the 30s. And the predominant boat is the Chris Craft boat. That's he was the largest builder of boats. So that's probably what you see the most of. But
and was he the first person to kind of commercialize boats as a building company, or?
He actually was. You know, some other companies that were started back in the 20s, you know, they never made it through the Depression and that sort of thing. But Chris Craft built almost 90,000 wood boats from the time they were in business. That's just the wood boat side. So
now, just looking at the design here, why is there two separate cabins kind of to sit in these older boats?
Well, this particular model here was introduced in 1947, and this is a Chris Craft called race boat. They actually built race boats. They sold them as race boats, and this had a very powerful engine in it. And this was built as a racer, and it had a little cover that went over the aft cockpit here, so it looked like just one station, and the driver rode in the front. But this little boat right here is 19 feet long. It was capable of traveling 50 miles an hour in 1947. They built it up from, they built it from 47 to 1954 when they discontinued it.
Now, you also do a little bit with restoration on your own?
Yes.
Something you like to do on the side?
Yeah, that's how I really got started as a hobbyist. I actually started restoring my own boats, and I've actually, I'm currently doing one right now, so this would be my 8th and final boat, so I'm finishing up here.
You're
I'm
sure not, about that? It's going to be your final boat?
I think so. I don't know if I want to take on another one. They're about 3-year projects, and that's a...
Are you talking start to finish, or is that just...
Yeah, it takes almost 3 years.
Restoring a boat, or is that building it from the ground up?
No, that's just restoring. It takes about 3 years for a single person to do it. I mean, meaning not a restoration facility where I'm not working full-time on it. But yeah, it's quite a process to redo it.
Now, while we're talking on restoration, you said you also have experts that come into the shows, and they talk a little bit about how they would do it.
On Saturday, we have what we call a symposium, the ACBS Symposium, and we've got like 9 different speakers there that speak for like an hour on certain subjects, and it's open to the public. So we'll do like this year. I know we're going to do a session on restoring the vintage steering wheels. That's pretty interesting because you can't buy these old parts, so you got to restore them. So we'll
very
have somebody there.
Very specific niche market that we're talking about here.
We'll have somebody teach them how to do varnishing. We'll have somebody there to talk vintage engines. Transmissions, that sort of thing, you know, people that are interested in doing their own work, so.
Okay. When you come to the show, you have a tent set up?
Yeah,
basically a booth?
We have a large display. We have a couple of tents. We have about 8 boats in our booth. People come to this event to see us to purchase a boat. It's just fantastic, and we are able to take them right out of our booth, right down the ramp, launch them, take people out for a ride.
So kind of like test driving a car.
You like test driving a car?
Same idea.
Exactly.
And the, go ahead.
No, this is just a great study in history, talking about this boat and what Chris Smith did. This is Americana, the building of these wooden boats, predominantly around the Great Lakes, although wooden boats were built all over the country. Chris Smith was just a master. He was an entrepreneur. I do believe he knew Henry Ford and worked on that assembly line process to build the boats that he built. And the ACBS, as we say, the Antique and Classic Boat Society, is really a group of people to preserve that American history. The members are passionate about their wood boats. There's a lot of wood boats out there. Most all of the 7,500 members have wood boats, and many of them have multiple wood boats. And care and use them. You know, I mean, some of them are in museums, but they actually take them out and put them in the water and have fun.
No, that's great. Along with you, how many other vendors do you have at your event?
This year I have 17 sponsors.
Wow.
Which is quite a large number for, you know, what we'd call a smaller event. But our show is very large. Our footprint on the ground is almost a third of a mile long. It's that big. It goes, and we're in a place called Wooten Park, which is owned by the city of Tavares, and the city has done a remarkable job of preparing this park and just making it really presentable to the public. And we should also mention that it's a seaplane base. You know, Tavares is now a designated seaplane base, so we got seaplane rides there and everything sitting right there in the middle of the boat show. And there's a vintage steam locomotive that runs right through the center of our show, and they'll be giving rides on Saturday, and they have staged robberies and all that. So we got, trains and planes and, you know, boats. And on Saturday, we got all the Central Florida Woody Car Club. They have about 25 Woody cars that come over and join the show, and they sit on display. So we got classic wood boats, classic wood cars, and it was just literally something for everybody. So it's just really a...
Now that you say something for everybody, so if I was to bring my kids down there, if I had them, what would they go about doing?
Well, we actually have a program that where we're teaching the younger kids, you know, how to build boats. So we have a little boat building there for younger kids. We have a program internally in our chapter called the Scampi Program, which is a program that we're having an auction Friday night to raise money for this program to teach kids. You know, how to build boats. We use it to buy engines for them. So we actually teach them how to build the boats, then we configure them, put the engines on, let them play with them and all that. So it's just a way to get them started in the hobby. So.
And you said Scampi, right? That's what the acronym is?
Yes.
And you have a fundraiser for them as well?
Yes, this is a huge fundraiser Friday night. It's at our captain's party. And we've got a lot of things on consignment that we're going to auction off there and some really neat items. So.
This is all part of the youth development program with the ACBS, trying to bring
really
young people into the hobby and get them driving the boats and building the boats.
Yeah, it's one of those things like, you know, baseball. It's such a big part of Americana, like
That's
you
right.
said.
That's
to
right.
be able to transfer that down is kind of neat. Yeah. As far as maintenance goes on one of these, how difficult is the upkeep versus something like a fiberglass boat?
Well, you know, they do restoration for a living, so why don't you tell them
so
how we do it?
So the fact that he has a job and just doing this means there's probably a little bit of restoration.
We restore these boats totally different now than when they were built, so we've learned to do it a different way, and they didn't have this technology when they built them, so with this new technology now, the maintenance has gone way down.
Okay, so I guess that we're going to defer over to you on this one.
Truly, if you're restoring one that is a gray boat, you know, one that has been left go behind the barn, it takes many, many man hours to bring one of those back. Not unlike doing a classic old car in terms of everything has to be done. It's all
stripped down,
okay?
Taken over.
Stripped down, replaced, rebuilt, refabricated, that type of thing. Once you get them into good condition, though, they're relatively easy to maintain. It is not that expensive to take care of. I've owned fiberglass as well as wood, and the fiberglass boats, after a few years, they take a lot to maintain also. They are low maintenance on the front end. But the other thing about a wood boat, being a broker as we sell these, a nice wood boat maintains its value. So once you have the boat and you have it in good condition, that value carries. It doesn't depreciate like the newer boats.
So very similar to any classic car.
Yes.
That
yes.
value is going to carry through years and years. Can you tell us about how many people are going to be there and a little bit about actual attendance and cost to get into this event?
Yes. We actually charge to get in the show. We offer free parking and we charge $5 a person $10 per weekend, which is nothing. That cost is used to basically maintain our docks. We have a beautiful set of docks there for everybody. We got docksility for all the boats, so you don't, you know, that which really makes it nice to come over there. But the cost is minimal when you think about what you get to see for $5. So,
absolutely. And what time do you open up to the public to come in?
We open Friday at tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock, and we go Friday and Saturday all day, and then a half a day on Sunday. And on Sunday we go to like noon, and then it's a slow wind down to get to everybody out of there. It's a huge process. We have 119 boats in the water, and probably the most unique thing about our show is we have a tractor valet service. When you come to our show, we meet you, we unhook the tow vehicle from the boat, and the boat trailer sits there, and then we have a tractor crew that comes up with tractors and picks up the boat and move it down and put it in the water. Then we store your trailer just like a valet service. Then when you get ready to leave, you come to us where you retrieve the trailer, get your boat, and send you on your way. So
that's great.
I've got to run this show. I tell you, it takes a lot of volunteers. And I've got over 200 volunteers to work this event, and I run this with committees. I got 28 different committees that makes up the leadership of the show. So behind
Excellent.
The scenes, it's really huge. So
I believe we have a phone call. Hello, caller. What is your question?
Yes, I was just wondering how old the boat has to be called an antique.
Just to reiterate that, how old does the boat have to be considered an antique, or is there not particularly an age?
Yes, there is a classification of boats, and
for registration purposes and
yes,
stuff like that.
Yes, there's a certain year for antiques, and then there's a certain year for classics, and I can't spit the number out exactly, but it's
antique is pre-war generally considered pre-war, mm-hmm, pre 1941.
Okay,
and then there's classics in a contemporary category also.
So somewhere past 50 to 60 years in that range. Okay. I believe we have some photos to look at of some of the motors. As soon as they come up, we can check those out and start talking about them. There we go.
Oh, this display here, this is part of the what we call the Antique Outboard Motor Club. This is just a sampling of what you're going to see there. And there's these motors in themselves are beautifully restored, and they all run, and then they have small boats there that are made to fit those motors. So not only do you see that, you'll see the boats there with them, and some of those are racing motors, like the one in the middle is a Mercury racing engine, and it goes on those little hydroplanes like that. And those boats, those were race boats in certain classes, and when you drove that boat, you actually had to sit on, you knelt down on your knees, and that's how they drove them. They were on your knees, and you...
Is that how you would... Yeah, that's steer and change the weight or what?
No, the steering's there tied to the engine, but you are on your knees to drive that. And I'm telling you, it was just torture on your knees, pounding you
to. What's the purpose of having you on your knees versus your legs straight out?
Well, the boat is too small.
You can't
do it on that particular boat there.
How many horsepower is that engine?
That's a Chris Craft 5-horse. That's an original Chris Craft 5-horse engine. Just another display there of some more beautiful outboards.
They're art in themselves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What are some of the ages of those motors right there?
Those are all 50 vintage in the 50s, from the 50s.
Neat. Mm-hmm. I remember growing up, my father actually had an Evinrude. I want to say it was 5 to 8 horsepower, really small. And we had that on our fishing boat that we would take up the river, because it was really easy to put on and take off ourselves because it was not that heavy. But I will tell you a funny story that you should never do, but never try to refill the gas while you're on the river, because the engine's hot. Mm-hmm. Bad things happen. So thank you, Dad, for that. Whenever you get to watch this, I would just like to let everyone know. What are some of your favorite things to do down here at the event when you come down, other than just, you know, talk to everyone about boats? What are some of the things that interest you?
Well, we see so many of our friends. We've been coming to this show for 17 years or more. Lou Rao, the founder of the Antique Boat Center, thought this would be a great show to bring our company down and show our wares. So we've been coming down here for a long time, and you just build friends. So many people have been to our shop, and then they come down here to the show. So it's like old home week. It's all your comrades, and it's just great fun. And there's a lot of people.
It's
and
like
of
a
course,
reunion every year?
Pardon?
Yeah. It's like a reunion
oh,
every
it
year?
Oh, it is like a reunion. And great. You get together and you go out to dinner and you have lunch with people, and it's just fantastic. And then the wide range of boats. There were several hundred manufacturers of wood boats in North America. And as Terry said, some of them never made it past the 20s. But you will see these very unusual boats, one-of-a-kinds that come down, and people have put their heart and soul into restoring them, and it's just, and each boat is art. I mean, it really
Absolutely.
Is.
I mean, just looking at them, it's pretty neat.
Just fantastic.
I believe we have another caller on the line. What is your question?
Yes, I was just wondering, do we get to see the boats moving at the show, or are they all just docked?
Part of our show is we encourage people to use the boats. So we've got boats constantly going in and out of the docks, and the people are welcome to walk around the docks and look at the boat. And it's amazing how many people will start talking to some of the boat owners, and they'll say, hey, jump in and we'll take you for a ride. So we don't advertise boat rides, but a lot of the owners like to take people for rides. And then one of the events we have is tomorrow we have a picnic that we go through the Dora Canal. You know, we're on Lake Dora, then there's this stunning, beautiful, mystic canal that takes us out into Lake Eustis called the Dora Canal. So we'll line up about 40 boats tomorrow around 10 o'clock, and we'll go single file through the Dora Canal over to Lake Eustis, and then we'll go up to a place called Hickory Point, and we have a picnic there. So everybody goes by boat, and then they tie the boats up there and have a picnic, and then they come back. So they get to use the boats and drive around and, you know, see some of the beautiful Florida waters here and that sort of thing. So, yes, we encourage people to use them. It's not a static show.
So, again, some of the ones that are for sale, it's kind of you can go out and test drive it and check them out like that.
Yes, if you're a serious buyer.
If you're obviously, yes, if you're interested in
test
buying
one, exactly. But the ones on the dock, they're just going in and out all day long. People are just going out for rides. Mm-hmm. They do photo shoots in the mornings. I mean, there'll be people out at the crack of dawn. It's just fantastic.
Do people go out fishing while they're out there? I mean, or is it more of a classy thing where we don't take our fishing rod out with us?
Well, we don't see many people fishing out of the aft cockpit of a racer.
I
you
guess
know?
That's probably.
I know.
Yeah. I don't see where you'd put your tackle box.
I know. They have never really gone together. You know, the mahogany boats were more, for families and, you know, more for that.
You said racing a lot of the times.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Truly, the Lyman, the feature boat this year, which the Lymans were built in Sandusky, Ohio. Bernard Lyman started that about the turn of the last century. And Lake Erie is known for the chop. It's a very shallow lake, so if the wind comes up, you can build
fours,
sixes, and eights very quickly. And the Lymans are actually unique in their design. They use a steam-bent oak rib, and then they're planked with overlapping planks on the side. It's called a lapstrake style, and they ride very nicely. And a lot of the Lyman utilities were fishing boats on Lake Erie, probably more fishing than anything else in the 40s and the 50s.
Not only that, they had side steering them, so you could fish in them, and you didn't have to be up in the cockpit. You could be in the back, and there was a steering wheel on the side, so you could side steer and side drive the boat and still fish. So, mm-hmm.
So these boats had many uses.
That's great. Mm-hmm. Just touching back upon this one here, because you actually sell this style of boat, correct?
Yes.
Now, what are some of the huge benefits of their remarketing the boat to fiberglass?
Well, most all of the boat manufacturers began to use fiberglass by the 1970s.
Okay.
Fiberglass is a product, really, of World War II.
Yes.
And so early into the 50s, you began to see what they called hybrids, and maybe they would have a cold-molded wooden hull with a fiberglass cap. And that was just the early days of fiberglass. People felt that the fiberglass would be much easier maintenance, and the wood boats went away.
Lighter as well, material-wise?
The wood is actually lighter than the fiberglass.
The wood is light, and that's another deceiving thing. People think wood boats weigh a lot, but they actually don't weigh that much. They're built with the structure and the strength of all the seams and the frames and the way they go together. The construction's actually light. Like this boat right here, the planks on the side of this boat are less than a half inch thick. So, you know, that's not very thick for a side plank. And the decks are a little, they're around 7/16 of an inch thick, so... When you add that up, it's not really heavy.
And everyone else, of course, when they come this weekend to check them out, they can see firsthand all of these boats. We're starting to run out of time here, so is there anything else really quick that you'd like to share with anyone watching about this weekend?
Well, I'd really like to invite all the viewers to come over because it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to see some really, really rare boats. I mean, especially some of the newly restored boats that are just stunningly beautiful. I mean, they're really pretty.
All the kids would enjoy it, too. It really is a family event.
That's great, and I've seen a lot of, again, it's very similar to classic cars with classic boats and the transfer and, of course, you know, keeping it in the family and letting everyone check it all out for the years to come down the line, which is great. And that's all you guys have? You sure? You don't want to throw anything out there?
Well, we have food vendors, and everybody likes to eat, so we have food vendors scattered throughout the park. So literally come over. You can
Perfect.
Spend a whole day there.
So all you need to do is show up, and everything else is taken care of.
It is.
And see the new Chris Craft.
And free parking.
And you can see the new Chris Craft, absolutely.
Yeah, and also free parking, I might add.
Free parking?
Yes.
Well, how can you say no to that? If you like boats, it's a great place to come. And we've actually run out of time, everyone. I would like to thank our guests, Terry Fiest and Dennis Ryan, for being with us tonight, and to all of our viewers for their calls. If you have any additional questions that you didn't get answered tonight, please email us at wdsc@daytonastate.edu. The Antique Boat Show is a great place for the entire family. Please find the time to visit the classic event this weekend. Be sure to catch us next week as we travel to another exciting Central Florida location. Until then, don't forget to visit your Central Florida. Thanks.